Danish Siddiqui, an award-winning photojournalist, was killed on 16th of July while covering a clash between the Afghan security forces and Taliban fighters near a border crossing with Pakistan. India has strongly condemned the killing of the Indian photojournalist in war-torn Afghanistan. For the past few days, the Pulitzer Prize-winning chief photographer was covering the tense situation in Afghanistan's Kandahar and had tagged along with the Afghan Special Forces on several missions. The Afghan Special Forces were fighting to retake the main market area of Spin Boldak in the Kandahar district when the Indian photojournalist and a senior Afghan officer were killed in what the Afghan officials described as Taliban crossfire. Earlier on Friday, the Indian journalist had been severely wounded in his arm while he was reporting on the clashes in Afghanistan. He was treated and had been recovering when the Taliban fighters retreated from the fighting in Spin Boldak. In a series of tweets, the Indian photojournalist reported how the vehicle that he was travelling in was targeted and that he felt lucky to be safe. Based in Mumbai, Danish Siddiqui graduated with a degree in economics from Jamia Millia Islamia in New Delhi. He also had a degree in mass communication from the AJK Mass Communication Research Center. Siddiqui began his journalistic career as a television news correspondent and later joined Reuters as an intern in 2010. Before being deputed to the war-torn country, he had already left a mark with his wonderful work in India. The Indian photojournalist had captured the pain of communal riots that shook the national capital in early 2020. He also had powerfully captured the moment when a shooter charged towards a group of anti-CAA protesters in the international capital in Delhi in 2020. Siddiqui had also covered the devastation caused by the second wave of the deadly coronavirus and the impact of the lockdown that was imposed to curb the spread of the virus. He also captured the heart-wrenching images of thousands of migrants walking back home amid the pandemic. From rural to urban parts of the country, Siddiqui travelled everywhere to capture the plight of the underprivileged amid the deadly pandemic and also bring to light the crippling health infrastructure in the country. Siddiqui had also covered the Nepal earthquake in 2015, the Battle of Mosul in 2016-17, and the 2020 protests in Hong Kong. In 2018, Danish Siddiqui and his colleague Adnan Abidi became the first Indians to receive the Pulitzer Prize for feature photography for documenting the Rohingya refugee crisis. His work has been widely published across global publications including New York Times, The Guardian, The Washington Post, Wall Street Journal, The National Geographic magazines, and much more. In his own words, he shoots for the common man who wants to see and feel a story from a place where he can't be present himself. Siddiqui's profile page on the Reuters website says that he liked covering everything from business to politics to sports, but what he enjoyed the most was capturing the human face of a breaking story. Danish Siddiqui's killing has triggered massive shockwaves across the world. Afghan President Ashraf Ghani said that he was deeply saddened with the shocking reports that the Reuters photojournalist was killed while covering the Taliban atrocities in Kandahar. Condoling his demise, Afghanistan's ambassador to India has also reacted and said that he was deeply disturbed by the sad news of killing of a friend in Kandahar last night. Information and Broadcasting Minister Anurag Thakur has also said that Danish Siddiqui leaves behind an extraordinary body of work. Reuters President Michael Fredenberg and Editor-in-Chief have also reacted and said that Danish was an outstanding journalist, a devoted husband and father, a much-loved colleague. The United Nations Secretary has also reacted and expressed grief at the killing of Indian photojournalist Danish Siddiqui in Afghanistan, with the UN mission in the war-torn country calling for an investigation into his killing as well as those of other reporters. The body of Danish Siddiqui was handed over to the International Committee of the Red Cross by Taliban on Friday. Danish Siddiqui, a passionate and brave Indian journalist, has left behind an extraordinary body of work. His love for the camera and the extensive coverage of the humanitarian crisis across the world and the human face of a breaking story will always be remembered.